This is the split direction lead, which used to be called the impossible lead, circa, I don't know, 2004-ish. Or the butterfly lead, if you hear anybody call it that, that's another old name for it as well. Okay, the split direction lead involves taking either the overhand lead or underhand lead pattern and doing it in the opposite direction. Here's what I mean by that. If you're doing a regular old-fashioned old overhand lead, this is just like what people normally call a 3D lead, what you're doing is you slow down, you're doing a continuous process of taking the bottom hand, bringing it home and crossing it on top. Bottom hand, bring it home and cross it on top. The bottom hand, home, cross it on top. And you're doing that again and again and again, and then you're taking out these little crossover circles in the middle until you have a pattern. Similarly, when you're doing an underhand pattern, you're taking the top hand home and crossing it underneath. The top hand home, cross it underneath. Top hand home, top hand home, top hand home, cross, top hand home, cross, top hand home, cross. Again and again and again, just taking out these extra little crossovers in between. So, for the split direction loop, we could do the same thing. We could do the overhand pattern or the underhand pattern. So if we have the left hand in overhand, the right hand in underhand, there's a bunch of things that I would recommend to lead up to it. First, and I know you all have done this, but as a review, one thing that will help is if you practice these, cross over right on top, cross over right on bottom, cross over left on top, and cross over left on bottom. Okay? That's step one. I know you've all already done them and we didn't do them in the class tonight, but they will help you too. Step two would be doing the two same time crossovers. The first one with the right hand on top, just this guy. My right hand is the orange one, my left hand is the green one. And then the other one is where you do the left on top. Style. So a right hand, two bead, split time, right on top, it's this one. My right hand's on top, my left is on bottom. This is just a two bead weave in opposite direction. With the right hand and underhand, left hand and underhand, right hand on top. This is the opposite one. It's a two bead weave where the left hand is on top and the right hand is on bottom, but the left hand is still an overhand and the right hand is still an underhand. So that's the next step. Once you can do all those, the final step to putting it together is with your left hand and overhand, your right hand and underhand, the two hands cross and in split time. To do the overhand pattern, this is for the overhand pattern, this is what we did in class except for you, Jan, did the other one. We took the bottom hand, brought it home, and crossed it on top. Bottom hand, home, and cross it on top. Bottom hand, home, cross on top. Bottom hand, home, on top. Bottom hand, home, on top. Again and again. Now, it may feel weird with the right hand because it's doing, right there, it's doing a little bit of anti-spin. That might feel similar to when you're doing a cat. It's that same motion, it's just that motion on the back side of the body. So drill that, and then try putting it together again. Now, you can also do the underhand pattern. The underhand pattern starts the same way, the arms are still crossed, but what you do is you take the top hand home and cross underneath. Top hand home underneath, top hand home underneath, top hand home underneath. Mm-hmm. Same thing that you are used to doing in like overhand and underhand.
Do you have to switch the way your arms are moving when you turn directions like you do with the other weave?
Ironically, no. I mean, you can cheat it. I have done it where you can go from overhand to overhand. You do have to go from side split left to side split right, but you don't have to go from